She said she too young, don't want no man. So she gon' call her friends, now that's a plan. I just saw the sushi from Japan. Now yo bitch wanna kick it, Jackie Chan.
Hey guys, welcome back to Spoilable Bastards. I'm Zach, and today we're gonna be introducing just a few of the cars that we have for you. And the first one is going to be our 2006 Bentley Flying Spur.
She said she too young, don't want no man. So she gon' call her friends, now that's a plan. I just saw the sushi from Japan. Now yo bitch wanna kick in Jackie Chan. She said she too young, don't want no man. So she gon' call her friends, now that's a plan. Kickin' Jackie Chan.
This car is pretty insane. It's 5,400 pounds, very heavy. Limousine type is what they call it. It's got a W12, which is it's a mid-engine weightless distribution type motor where they put it in front of the axles to, I guess, even out all the weight. Usually most cars with V12s are mid-engine, so they'll be higher behind the axle. It's pushing 550 horsepower with 470 pound-feet of torque, probably a little bit more. And it's just an insane sedan. Cheaper than a Cadillac new. We did a lot to it so far. We've done the tires and rims. We put HREs, they're 22s. We got special design calipers and rotors. I think we're actually the first Bentley to ever get them because they don't make an aftermarket system for them. And so R1 Concepts built a front and rear, and they're badass. Interior wise, we did the infotainment system. It was kind of an older, non-usable, no Bluetooth system, and it just didn't look good. So we bought one from a newer Flying Spur and put it in, and now it's got Bluetooth, which is useful. The stereo system in it actually is very, very keen. It works. You don't need a whole bunch of shit for it. And that's pretty much it. You just take it in and you see this going down the road and you're just like, wow. I mean, it's a fast car. It's insane. It's not meant to go super, super fast, but it'll top out at 200. And it's just a beautiful, beautiful car. It's got 650 horsepower with 500 pound-feet of torque, weighs 4,100 pounds. As you guys will see, or you guys already saw, it sounds ungodly. They call it, Ferrari says it's like a hatchback, and I look at it like a clown shoe. It's got 21-inch wheels on the front, 22 inches on the back, Revossens. We didn't touch a whole lot onto this car. A lot of it, like I said, was just the tires and the rims, and everything else is self-explanatory. I mean, this car is a lot of fun. Tunnels are a lot of fun. We bought it with like 40,000 miles on it, which is a lot for a Ferrari, but it came with a good price. And everything else about this car is just insane. This is probably one of my favorite cars out of all of what we've got. The reactions you get from people and everything else comes with it is just, like I said, it's kind of speechless, honestly. I don't know why no one would want. I'd rather have this than a 458 or a 48. It's not as fast, but it's a lot of fun.
You bring your friend to next time.
Welcome to the party. Welcome to the party.